जय हिंद। दिस इज कंप्यूटर बेस्ड ट्रेनिंग फॉर एनसीसी कैडेट्स ऑन द टॉपिक डिजिटल अवेयरनेस। आई एम हियर टू मेक यू अवेयर ऑन वेरियस वाइड स्प्रेड डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजीज। नाउ पॉइंट इज दिस, व्हाट इज डिजिटल अवेयरनेस? डिजिटल यूजुअली रिफर्स टू समथिंग यूजिंग डिजिट्स, पर्टिकुलरली बाइनरी डिजिट्स। It describes electronic technology that generates, stores, and processes data in terms of binary digits, that is 1 and 0. And as far as awareness is concerned, it is the state of being conscious of something. We can say that digital awareness or digital intelligence is the ability to use digital technology, communication tools, or networks to locate, evaluate, use and create information. Digital devices such as computing and communication instrument and tools such as databases enable access management and creation of digital information. These means of interacting with digital information are viewed as networking devices rather than simply computing devices. In a simple word, we can say that digital awareness means that one is able to understand and utilize technology in an increasingly interconnected world. Digital awareness really acknowledges the profound impact that technology has had our lives, both personally and professionally. We are surrounded by numerous new technologies and we are using these on a daily basis, but we really know how this works? Probably you won't be knowing every technological aspect. Now, as far as digital awareness is concerned, it's having two aspects. First is positive aspect, that you are aware each and everything about digital technology, and second one is negative aspect, that you are unaware about digital technology or you are having incomplete knowledge of digital technology. Now come to the positive aspects. Positive aspect of digital awareness. Digital technology has radically transformed almost every aspect of life in recent years, including the workplace. The transformation in the workplace, particularly digital, provides flexibility and agility to workers, improving their overall performance and productivity. Example at workplace of a digital technologies are Google LLC, limited liability company, is an American multinational technology company that specializes in internet related services and products, which include online advertising technologies, a search engine, cloud computing, software and hardware, internet. Biometric attendance, that is called e-attendance, e-salary. Communication, which means e-communication, whether it is communicate via smart Android phone, 3G, 4G, 5G, 6G and 7G spectrum. In India, we are using up to 5G, and in Japan, they use 7G. It is the 7th generation of broadband cellular work. Then WhatsApp, Telegram, LinkedIn, Twitter, email, all are these social media. Study means e-learning. Examples of e-learnings are tablets, e-classes, live online classes via Zoom app, Cisco WebEx, Google Classroom, Facebook Live, Google Meet, Skype, YouTube Live, Smart Classroom. Now, digital literacy. The American Library Association defines digital literacy as the ability to use information and communication technologies to find, evaluate, create, and communicate information requiring both cognitive and technical skills. Digital literacy initially focused on digital skills and standalone computer. the advent of the internet and use of social media has caused some of its focus to shift to mobile devices. Travel means e-travel. Examples of e-travels are e-tickets like e-air tickets, e-train tickets, e-ship tickets, e-bus tickets, even e-tour packages, and many more. Banking, which means e-banking, virtual banking. Virtual or internet banking is a system where all the transactions of the bank are done online and there are no physical branches of banks. Also, there is no banking hours and thus customers can operate their accounts at any time of the day. Many banks also allow to open new accounts online. Online banking, internet banking, mobile banking, etc. In India, since 1997, when the ICICI Bank first offered internet banking services, today, in fact, all major banks provide e-banking services to their customers. Now, e-commerce. Examples are e-shopping, e-payment, ATM, and automated teller machine. Paytm. Paytm is India's number one smart e-wallet. Paytm was founded in August 2010 by Sri Vijay Shekhar Sharma at Noida. Bheem app, Bharat Interface for Money. It is a payment app that you can make direct bank payments to anyone on UPI. UPI means Unified Payment Interface, using their UPI ID or scanning their QR, quick response code, with the Bheem app. Digital signature. Digital money means bits coin. Cryptocurrency. Digital camera. Digital clock. Self-driving car and artificial intelligence. Drone camera. So there are so many examples with respect to this digital technology. A digital shoe, digital pen, Hawkeye camera. Hawkeye camera is used in various games like in cricket to see the LBW, the ball direction, in tennis for in and out of ball, in badminton, in and out of shuttlecock, etc. Digital medical equipment like glucometer, sphygmomanometer, and many more. Digital board, digital ground level machine. Now, with over 560 million internet users are in India. India is the second largest online market in the world, ranked only behind China. Digital awareness play a role in the unstoppable growth in internet use for social and business purpose. It will benefit online trading and social media marketing, understanding your online identity, using social networking, monitoring and promoting your business, protecting your online privacy, increasing your computer security, protecting your digital assets. Now come to negative aspect that you are unaware about digital technology or you are having incomplete knowledge of digital technology. Lack of digital awareness causing security threat. Some of the going digital fraud you need to be aware of are keylogger. A keylogger is a software that records the keystrokes made by the user on the keyboard mobile. Using a dynamic PIN is a smart solution to breach caused by keyloggers. Fake calls. Someone may fake calls the cardholder and pretend to be a representative of the bank, acting as if an online transaction needs to be confirmed and subsequently ask the cardholder to share the received OTP. When the OTP is disclosed by the cardholder, a fraudulent transaction can take place. OTP pop-ups. OTP mostly appear as pop-up notification on mobile phone. These pop-up messages are clearly visible even if the mobile phone is locked. This means that OTP can be easily accessed without the permission of the user, making the transaction open to being breached. EDC machine. Swiping a card on EDC machine is not as safe as it seems. EDC means electronic data capture machine, are susceptible to breach, and a compromised machine can copy the details of the cards when shipped. A dynamic PIN for physical credit or debit card should be strong safeguard against compromised EDC machine. That's why you have to change your password after every 15 days. OTP accessibility. One time password is sent as an SMS. The problem with this is that many apps can read SMS messages. This means that if an app is malicious, it can misuse the OTP that has been received. Therefore, users should be aware of what privileges they give to the apps on their smartphone, and also look at reviews and number of downloads of the apps they choose. I'll also tell you about general fraud and unaware with respect to digital technology, that is digital signature. Keep your public and private key means public and private password. Online auction and store fraud. Misrepresentation. Seller deliberately values an item incorrectly and alter the picture of to make the item seem like a superior product. Non-delivery of orders and paid goods. Black market and counterfeit. Online lottery contest and sweepstakes fraud. Have you ever received a sweepstakes or lottery promotion in your email account? Prizes and sweepstakes scam. You may have received a sweepstakes or special prize promotion via email. The reshipping racket. In this scam, persons are recruited for the sole purpose of accepting packages at their homes, which they then repackage and send to another place. Click on advertising banner, social medias, or anything in a pop-up window. Respond to emails from a stranger on anyone they are not expecting. Communication from before checking with you first. Download anything unless you approve it first. Share any information with a stranger on website or social media. Forward emails to a mass group, forum, social media site, or message board. Order anything online without your knowledge. Accept a gift, text, picture, or anything else online without talking to you first. Post photos of themselves online or via text message. A scam where someone poses as their grandchild in need of financial help. False offer for free or discounted medication or medical equipment. Credit card fraud and investment scam, and so many more. Now, conclusion. Digital fraud don't affect a large percentage of people, but that doesn't mean it's not a big problem. And if they affect you, they are very big problem indeed. It is critical to protect yourself. So please aware about all the key digital technologies like digital basics, Internet of Things, cryptocurrency, artificial intelligence, mobility, analytic and big data, social media, cloud, robotic process automation, and many more. Hopefully, this presentation has given you the tools you need to stay safe. Thank you. Jai Hind.